Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about the signs and symptoms of a bad catalytic converter. Additionally, I'll talk a little bit about the causes of catalytic converter failure, as well as walk you through some diagnostic and testing steps that you can take to determine if you do have a bad catalytic converter or not. A catalytic converter is the main emissions component within the exhaust system of a vehicle. Its whole purpose is to reduce the amount of carbon dioxide that is coming out of your exhaust system and therefore creating cleaner and healthier exhaust gases. A catalytic converter has a unique internal structure. If you look at the inside of one of them, it looks like it has a honeycomb filter. And that honeycomb filter is actually made out of rare earth metals. And what happens is as those exhaust gases pass through these rare earth metals, it creates a chemical reaction, which reduces the amount of carbon dioxide within the exhaust gases, therefore reducing overall emissions. Generally speaking, there's two things that can happen to your catalytic converter that can cause it to fail. First of all, it can clog up, and the second thing is it could completely hollow out. Regardless of which happens, this will lead to a number of performance-related issues that we'll go ahead and talk about. But first off, let's go ahead and talk about these two scenarios and talk about why it happens. So the most common thing that happens is the catalytic converter clogs up, and what that means basically is that that honeycomb mesh structure inside the exhaust system essentially melts and then creates a barrier for the exhaust gases to pass through. This typically happens when you have some ignition-related issues with your vehicle. If you're having misfires or you've got bad spark plugs, ignition coils, etc., what happens is fuel gets dumped into the combustion chamber. That cylinder then doesn't ignite, and then that fuel then gets passed into the exhaust system, which is extremely hot, and the fuel ends up actually combusting within the exhaust system when it meets that honeycomb structure on the catalytic converter. And what that will do is create extremely high temperatures that can melt that honeycomb structure from the catalytic converter. And as it melts them, it will slowly and slowly clog up the catalytic converter and restrict airflow. When this happens, you obviously have a huge restriction because your exhaust gases aren't able to get out of the engine quickly enough, and they therefore are going to create back pressure that's going to work against the engine and lead to a number of other performance related issues. Now, if you're lucky, you can actually completely hollow out your catalytic converter as well, which basically means you burn through that whole honeycomb structure, but rather than it clogging up and getting stuck in there, it actually is gonna blow out through the exhaust system, and it's basically gonna take away the whole catalytic converter part of the exhaust pipe and leave you with a hollowed out exhaust pipe. It's gonna cause less performance related issues if this happens, but it will cause you to fail emissions tests. So those are typically the two different things that happen. You can either have it clog or you can completely hollow it out. Generally speaking, having it completely hollowed out is gonna be better because it's not gonna lead to as many of these performance related issues. With that being said, let's go ahead and talk about some of the common signs and symptoms of catalytic converter failure. Some of the things that you might notice is rough idling, cylinder misfires, you might have trouble accelerating or accelerating past a certain RPM or past a certain speed. You'll have a loss of power, decreased fuel economy. You'll fail emissions tests. Your engine will typically be running hotter or you'll have a lot higher exhaust gas temperatures. And a lot of times you will get a check engine light, but there is no check engine light specific to the catalytic converter itself. There's nothing in there to tell you when the catalytic converter goes bad. And so your engine codes are typically going to be related to the O2 sensors or related to your air to fuel ratios. You have an O2 sensor that sits before the catalytic converter and one that sits after it. And the purpose is to measure the amount of oxygen in the air to be able to determine if the catalytic converter is doing its job properly. If the reading before the catalytic converter is the same as the reading after the catalytic converter, that means that your catalytic converter is not working properly, and that's going to throw an O2 sensor code. If you have a clogged up catalytic converter, that's typically when you're gonna notice some of these more noticeable symptoms, like not being able to accelerate past a certain speed, or a significant loss in power. Not having a catalytic converter is actually good for performance reasons. So if you completely hollow out your catalytic converter, you're not really gonna have as many of these performance related issues, but you are gonna have engine codes for your O2 sensors, and it can throw off your air to fuel ratios, which can cause some rough idling and other smaller performance related issues, but you're probably not gonna have the more serious ones like you would if you clog up your catalytic converter. So if you have these symptoms, it can be a little bit difficult to diagnose whether it is the catalytic converter or not, just because the engine codes aren't gonna point you specifically to it. You're likely gonna get a number of engine codes for cylinder misfires and air to fuel ratios and things that could also be caused by fueling related problems, ignition related problems, and a number of other things. So it can be a little bit tricky to diagnose whether it's the catalytic converter that's bad or not. And so to test that, there's a couple different testing options that you can go through to try to figure it out. I'd say if you completely hollow out your catalytic converter, probably one of the easiest ways to tell is you're gonna notice it in the smell of your exhaust. Your exhaust smells are gonna be a lot more noticeable. They're gonna smell a lot more fuel-y and smell a lot worse. And so you will notice from the smell of it if you completely hollow out your catalytic converter. But unfortunately, catalytic converters probably clog up more frequently. And if it clogs up, it can be a little bit more difficult to test it. But we've got a couple tests here to go ahead and walk you through to be able to confirm whether or not it's clogged. The first and probably easiest option is to remove the O2 sensor that sits before the catalytic converter. The reason being, when your catalytic converter clogs up, it creates a ton of back pressure within the exhaust because that exhaust air doesn't have anywhere to go to get out of the exhaust system more quickly. So if we unplug the O2 sensor, that creates a nice little hole in our exhaust system for the air to get out of, which means the air can efficiently get out of the vehicle. So if you unplug the O2 sensor and you notice a lot of your signs and symptoms are going away, then you have a clogged up catalytic converter. The second thing that you can do is do a vacuum gauge test. Basically, you'll need a vacuum gauge and you'll have to hook it up to a vacuum port. Most vehicles have a vacuum port that feeds to the brake booster, which is a good one to test it off of. But basically, what you're going to want to do is hook your vacuum tester up to a vacuum line, and then you'll want to go ahead and idle your engine and see what your vacuum readings are at idle, and then go ahead and give it gas and slowly creep up the RPMs and see what happens to your vacuum readings. If your vacuum readings at higher RPMs are lower than your vacuum readings at idle, then you have a clogged up catalytic converter. And the third test that you can do is a back pressure test. For this, you're gonna hook up a low pressure tester to the O2 sensor port that's located before the catalytic converter. And we're gonna go ahead and read the amount of pressure within the exhaust system before the catalytic converter. Now, back pressure at idle should probably be somewhere around 1.5 PSI or pounds of pressure. As you slowly accelerate, right around 2000 RPMs, you should probably be around 3 PSI of pressure. What you'll wanna do is hook it up, take your readings at idle, and then slowly accelerate the vehicle and see what happens to the pressure readings. If you're getting really big jumps in pressure and your pressure's getting really high, then that means that you're gonna have a clogged up catalytic converter, because what that's doing is creating a lot more back pressure within the exhaust system. Now, any of these three tests are very helpful and good tests to tell whether your catalytic converter is clogged up. As I mentioned, you're not gonna necessarily be able to tell if it's completely hollowed out through these tests. You can if you do the back pressure tests. If you do the back pressure tests and you have very minimal back pressure at idle, and as you accelerate, the gains in back pressure are very minimal, then it could be completely hollowed out, because then you have nothing that's restricting the exhaust flow within the vehicle, and so you're gonna have very low levels of back pressure. The biggest downside to catalytic converter issues is that, one, they're a required emissions component, so if you have a problem with them, you're going to have to fix it, but they're also very expensive just because they do use rare earth metals to help create the chemical reactions to reduce emissions, and so they are expensive to replace when you have a problem with it. Whether it's clogged up or completely hollowed out, you are gonna have to replace that to be emissions compliant and pass emissions testing. So because these are expensive, you're probably gonna want to go through these testing processes, at least one of them, to make sure that your catalytic converter is the issue before you go ahead and replace it, which is then gonna cause a number of performance issues that I mentioned. Generally speaking, diagnostic-wise, the best place to start is reading your engine codes and seeing what engine codes you have and then doing a little bit of digging online to see if you can figure out what the most common cause of that engine code is for your vehicle. There are a lot of other things that can cause the same symptoms as a bad catalytic converter. And so because these are expensive, we want to go ahead and try to figure out what the right fix is before throwing money into a new catalytic converter. As you guys try to diagnose what's going on with your vehicle, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or need any help, please throw something down in the comments and I'll do my best to get back to you. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future videos.